friends, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, sir.
Hello, sir.
Very good afternoon.
Good afternoon, sir.
Have a good, successful day. So far, 54 students already joined. So we can start now. Okay. Acha. So, can one of you kindly tell me that last class, what was the last topics we have discussed? Can you only tell me, any of you, in last class, what was the last topics we discussed? Then further we'll proceed from that point. What was that? Shrimanti?
Sir?
Last one point of Puriya Shila?
Sir, you told about phosphorescence and fluorescence.
For the Puriya Shila? Very good. Phosphorescence, what a discussion. Take, very good. Acha, now it is clear. Phosphorescence, shall I repeat? This phenomenon that luminescence, the main thing, that emission of energy in the form of light, then these luminescence, there are two types on the basis of the nature of the excited state of the excited state of the electron. Okay. Acha. So what are the points I am telling you? All of you, please note down. Because after covering some more areas, that then I will announce that assignment that I'll be arranging. So, because as per Markov syllabus, we have to arrange that continuous assessment by whatever the method. So anyway, I'm planning that I'll give some assignment that is having few number of questions, so you have to write it. Clear? So marks is 25 marks, total marks of that. Okay. Now that so we know the luminescence phenomenon. What is this? That is the emission of energy of electrons from higher energy excited level to lower energy level or ground state. So this excess energy, what is released, it converts in the form of light. So this phenomenon is called luminescence. Then this luminescence, there are two varieties. One is phosphorescence, another is fluorescence. So fluorescence is more widely used than phosphorescence. So fluorescence, what it is? So fluorescence is what it is? When that electrons, after reaching the excited state, it tries immediately come back or jump to the original ground state or lower energy level within a time gap of less than nanosecond, 10 to the minus 9 second. Got my point? That means ground state electron, by absorption of energy from the ray, light, or whatever, environment, jump to the excited level, and from there, that level, immediately it tries to come back to the lower energy level. So that way, what light is formed or coming due to the emission of energy by the electrons, so that phenomenon is fluorescence phenomenon, and light is called fluorescence. Okay. And in the case of phosphorescence, that ground state electron after reaching the hello after reaching the that excited level, spends some time, not immediately comes back to the ground state. It spends some time and then comes back. That means delayed return to the ground state. So in this fashion, while coming back to the ground state after spending some time in the excited state, then hello, what happened? Hello? I could not hear. What happened? Very attentively listen. This is a very interesting subject and not much complication is there. Only you have to go through 3-4 times so that these are the things you have to absorb and you have to remember so that in the exam hall you can write them. So these are the what are the points I am discussing, that minutely note down, then go through at residence, refer to this book, reference book, and nowadays know why that very big questions are given, why that very long answer to be written, all are the short type or medium. So that way you read and study accordingly. So all right. So now, so these are the basic principles of whatever the way question coming. Hello? হ্যাঁ, কে বলছেন? না না, এখন বিজি আছে না, পরে ঠিক আছে। আচ্ছা, সো দিস আর দ্য প্রিন্সিপলস অফ হোয়াট এভার ওয়ে দি কোশ্চেন কামিং, প্রিন্সিপলস অফ লুমিনেশন অর ফসফোরেসেন্স অর ফ্লুরেসেন্স ইউ হ্যাভ টু রাইট। Then in the MCQ stage also, sometime that what type of materials exhibit the fluorescence, that question comes. So this fluorescence phenomenon, I am going a bit slow so that you can absorb. Just very attentively listen, very attentively listen. So first, when this fluorescence light was discovered by the scientist, so that was almost in 1850. So that time they found the fluorescence light is coming out from calcium fluoride, whose mineral form name is fluorite. Fluorite, F-L-U-O-R-I-T-E, or fluorspar. So on that basis, this phenomenon named fluorescence. Apart from calcium fluoride, some other organic compounds also exhibit fluorescence. So what are those? Next, quinine. Second example, quinine. Q-U-I-N-I-N-E. Quinine. Third example is fluorescence. This is also polynuclear polynuclear organic compounds, FLUORESCEIN. Another, rhodamine, RHODAMINE. And fifth one is anthracene, polynuclear aromatic compound. These are the these are the examples of fluorescent compounds. And in the phosphorescence, normally these phosphorescent materials are added to the paints or your stars like that, so which glow in the dark. So these materials absorb the light from the surroundings, and normally these materials used in the paints and this sort of material. Okay. So now next question may come like this. What are the theories or mechanism of fluorescence? The question may be any style. So what is the theory or principles or mechanisms of fluorescence phenomenon? So this phenomenon is widely discussed and studied by the scientist Professor Alexander Jablonski. And according to so after that, the diagram or mechanism by which these fluorescence and phosphorescence phenomenon takes place is called Jablonski diagram. Clear? So if the question is coming, write down the Jablonski diagram to explain the phenomenon of fluorescence and phosphorescence. Then you have to give this diagram, and this diagram is available in any reference book. So what is the diagram consists of? So in the case of fluorescence, that that ground state electron, it goes to the excited state in both the cases, that the state is the single state. Then from the upper excited state, it by the internal conversion, say it comes back to another excited single state, and then immediately comes back to ground state. So here that transition singlet to singlet state. Whereas in the case of phosphorescence, so here electron moves from the ground state to tip state, excited, then it from tip state to, after spending some time, it immediately jumps to the ground state. So you have to give this diagram, and basic difference you should know. In the case of fluorescence, that transition between a singlet ground state to singlet excited state. In this case, here triple state 2, then ground state 2, triplet excited state 2, triplet ground state. So this you have to give. There another important area of this, that just like UV and visible spectrometer you already studied, there are five important components. So that is that five components everywhere, whatever the spectrophotometer, you have to study in your this syllabus, UV and visible spectrophotometer, then fluorescence spectrophotometer, or another nuclear magnetic resonance spectrophotometer, and MRI. So these are the four spectrophotometer you have to study. What my point? So basic component wise, in the case of UV, whatever you have seen, that will be there, plus with some modification will be there. That means that modification for different characteristics of the spectrophotometer. Clear? So here the fluorescence spectrophotometer, what are the components? Number one, that is the light source. Light source means that which provide the light or ray which by irradiation on the substance cause the excitation of electron from ground state to excited state, higher energy excited state. Okay, number one. Number two, that monochromator. Monochromator means that selector of wavelength, because with respect to different spectrum or spectra, you have to select certain light of certain wavelength. So from the source, when you are getting the light, that consists of lights of so many different wavelengths. So from there, by monochromator, you have to segregate that what particular wavelength light you want. So monochromator will select that. Then there will be a sample cell which consists of a solution of your particular solvent along with the substance which you are going to investigate. So that sample cells will be there. Then further your excitation monochromator will be there. Then from there you will select the only fluorescence type of beam which will fall on the detector to measure the intensity of the light, and then it will reach to that receiver or fluorescence recorder. So these are the instrumentation side of fluorescence spectrophotometer. Okay. Hello, students. Could you understand? Hello? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Very good. So then, after the instrumentation part, Then another important application or uses. Application and uses. So, and especially in fluorescence spectrophotometers, apart from your, that what type of job that ultraviolet and visible spectrometer is to do, some other also jobs you can get from these fluorescence spectrophotometer. These are your biological field, then your pollution control field, then nanotechnology, biotechnology, in this field also used, plus in the medical application also, these are widely used medical applications, such as by using the lesser induced fluorescence spectroscopy, you can diagnose that very critical diseases of the human body, mainly cancer, this sort of things. Yes. So this fluorescent light is used for imaging and detecting the tumor. This is one very important application. Then another for your dish thing, what is called the diabetes patient or other things. So what is their sugar level and monitoring that sugar level, this is very widely used. So these are the application side of fluorescence spectra. Clear? Now we'll switch over compared to other sections. Your progress is quite high because all classes we could do. Other cases, holiday and other things were there. Anyway, let us see. Now, very important spectroscopy is NMR spectroscopy. NMR spectroscopy. That what it is? That is nuclear magnetic resonance spectroscopy. And magnetic resonance imaging, MRI. So, these are the spectra you have to study. So that way, these three spectrophotometer you have to study well. One is ultraviolet and visible spectrophotometer. Second one is fluorescence spectrophotometer. Third one is nuclear magnetic resonance spectrometer, and fourth one is magnetic resonance imaging spectrophotometer. So these four.
Which was third one? Third one, can you say more? Sir, third one, can you say again? Third one.
Nuclear magnetic resonance within bracket capital NMR. Nuclear magnetic resonance within bracket NMR spectrophotometer or spectroscopy, whatever you define. Okay. Then fourth one is what we are calling MRI, spectrophotometer, MRI, magnetic resonance imaging, within bracket capital MRI.
Fourth is
magnetic resonance imaging within bracket capital MRI. magnetic resonance imaging spectrophotometer. Clear? So, what is that? So, here, a method is a little bit complicated compared to other two. Here, instrumentation part. So, what the basic five components will be there. Then in that, some sort of little change is there. Suppose here that irradiating that energy that will vary, and that nuclear magnetic resonance spectroscopy, if you open up this name, then you will get the answer. That means any atom is what is called that exposed in a magnetic field, in a exposure. We used to call that exposure. Have you got that exposure? Money, have you faced or have you experienced?
Okay, sir.
From exposure, it has come exposed. So if you exposed, then what happens? That if that from magnetic field, that what energy will be falling on the substance, and if it is coinciding with the nuclear energy, then there should be some enhancement or resonance. There should be resonance. So by that way, your that transition, so absorption as well as emission, this will take place. Got my point? So these are the, and in the case of MRI also, a little bit change, here only, here source of energy or light will be a little bit different, okay. So after finishing this, two spectrophotometers will switch over to your different surface characterization techniques, different methods. So next class, we will discuss that nuclear magnetic resonance spectroscopy in detail, and as well as different types of techniques which are available to characterize the surface of the substance. So that way, you can note down. So if you can read at home, so next class, interaction will be better. So there are so many methods. So, and important that we'll discuss. So by that way, in your case, progress is better and module 2 will be over. So in your case, after the next class, then we'll switch over to that module number 3, intermolecular forces and potential energy surfaces. So write down that what are the techniques for surface characterization. Number 1, contact angle analysis. Contact angle analysis, by that way you can characterize the surface. Then another you may be knowing, very popular, light microscopy. Second method, light microscopy. Then number three, your X-ray diffractometer or X-ray photometer, whatever, by using the X-ray type of light or radiation. Then another, electron spectroscopy for chemical analysis. This is then your transmission electron microscopy, transmission. This is one method by which you can characterize the surface, transmission electron microscopy.
Sir, can you repeat once again, please repeat, sir.
I'll repeat. This is the transmission electron microscopy within bracket TEM, capital TEM, transmission electron microscopy, TEM. This is one method very popular and important. Only thing is that online is very difficult to show that operation and this thing. Anyway, so
yes, I'll sir, try very difficult.
Very difficult, I know, but online that pleasure, that interaction is not at all is by this online techniques. But this is the situation, we do not know when that normal situation will come. One after another, first wave has gone, then second wave, then again pata nahi when the third wave will be coming. So anyway, we have to adjust the whatever we are getting, the opportunities.
Sir, when will be our second semester examination?
Second, most possibly June end or July.
Will it be online or offline, sir?
Now, question, forget about offline, all online. Forget about. Offline, kab aayega? Very difficult, very difficult. One up.